Interstitial lung disease is a term that can be used to describe any respiratory disorder that causes scarring of the tissues within the lungs. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. As previously mentioned, interstitial lung disease is a broad term used to describe a group of lung disorders that cause fibrosis or scarring of lung tissue. This results in stiffness, which decreases lung compliance and oxygenation, and makes it more difficult to breathe. Unfortunately, once this type of lung damage has occurred, it's typically irreversible and progressively gets worse over time. Interstitial lung disease has several known and unknown causes. Some examples include connective tissue diseases, autoimmune diseases, malignancy, drug-induced, infections, and inhaled substances. Interstitial lung disease can occur secondary to certain connective tissue and autoimmune diseases, such as sarcoidosis, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, systemic sclerosis, and polymyositis. It is also caused by the inhalation of toxic substances, such as asbestosis, silicosis, hypersensitivity pneumonitis, and other occupational and environmental toxins. There are also certain drugs and medications known for causing interstitial lung disease. Some examples include antibiotics, chemotherapy drugs, and certain anti-arrhythmic agents. And lastly, interstitial lung disease is caused by certain infections such as atypical pneumonia, RSV, and tuberculosis. It is also known for causing a number of different signs and symptoms. Some examples include shortness of breath, chest discomfort, fatigue, non-productive cough, weight loss, and hypertension. In general, these signs and symptoms typically develop slowly over several months. The treatment for interstitial lung disease varies depending on the patient's symptoms. Some of the standard treatment methods include oxygen therapy, corticosteroid medications, pulmonary rehabilitation, and lung transplantation. The treatment method may also vary depending on the specific cause. For example, if the cause is due to inhalation of a toxic substance, the best treatment would be to avoid said substance. Or if a specific medication is the known cause, the patient should stop taking that medication. But again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was helpful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.